We can apply the same logic and define elasticity of demand for imports. Let's say the United States is buying or importing umbrellas from that's made in China. And umbrellas used to sell for $10, and China is able to sell 15,000 umbrellas to American consumers. Now China decides, oh, we're going to make umbrellas $5 more expensive, so it costs $15 each. As a result of this price increase, American consumers decide to buy fewer umbrellas. As a result, demand dropped from 15,000 to 10,000 units. In this example, what is the elasticity of demand? Well, we need to calculate the percentage change in quantity and divide that by the percentage change in price. Price increased from 10 to 15, so the change in price is 15 minus 10, which is $5. Divided by the original price will give us the percentage change in price. So 5 divided by 10, the percentage change in price is 50%. Similarly, in terms of quantity, the United States used to be able to buy 15,000 units, which dropped to 10,000 units after the price increase. So the change in quantity is 10,000 minus 15,000, which is negative 5,000, measuring quantity declines by 5,000. Divided by the original quantity, which is 15,000, give us the percentage change in quantity, which is negative 33%. Having both percentage change in quantity and the percentage change in price, we can calculate the elasticity, which is 33% divided by 50%, or there is an elasticity of 0.66.